Final Miami Dolphins mock draft of 2021. The mock drafts have been steadily flying since September of last year, and now, all fans have a chance to see if they can actually predict how these dominoes will potentially fall. With that being said, here is my final and latest Miami Dolphins mock draft. First round, 6th overall, Ja'Marr Chase, WR, LSU. Chase is the best wide receiver in this year's draft class, and he is the type of player that is missing from the Miami Dolphins. You pair Chase with Fuller and you now have an inside-out game that the Dolphins haven't seen in a long time. I do think this puts Devontae Parker on the block, so watch out for trade on day 2 or 3. First round, 18th overall, Najee Harris, RB, Alabama. Someone has stated you don't take running backs in the first round, but I honestly believe if you love a player, you take him. Add in the fact that I think the Steelers and Bills will take a running back in the back end of the first round, and Atlanta needs ones right before our pick in the second round, so if the Dolphins want to secure the best in class, do it now. Also, reuniting Harris with Tua automatically makes Tua happy. Second round, 36th overall, Zaven Collins, LB, Tulsa. Everything about Collins screams first round talent, but let's be honest, if a linebacker pushes a 4.8 40 times and weighs in at 270, he will drop in the draft. Collins' production on the field has been legit, and the Dolphins would look to use the Miami Heat to slim him down and get him in shape. Think of Collins as the younger version of Kyle Van Noy. Second round, 50th overall, Landon Dickerson, C, Alabama. Yes, the Dolphins traded Ereck Flowers yesterday, but they need a center right now, more than a tackle. This draft is all about Tua, and you have to reunite him with players he knows and understands. Landon would be a first-round pick, but his injury late in the season cost him that, but his play will automatically boost the Dolphins' line. Third round, 81st overall, Stone Forsythe, tackle, Florida. This kid is huge, 6'9 and 300+. He's got great strength and movement, and it would fit nicely into the Dolphins' need for a starting tackle to compete with Jesse Davis. With the Dolphins' line of Austin Jackson, Solomon Kindley, Landon Dickerson, Robert Hunt, Stone Forsythe, Jesse Davis, that is something to look forward to. Fifth round, 156th overall, Quincy Roche, defensive end, Miami. All the talk surrounding that U is on two players, but to be honest, Roche is a sneak player that could look to make a difference. His burst at the line of scrimmage is great, and he's got great bend and acceleration to the ball. With proper mentoring from Coach Flores, this could be a great pickup. Seventh round, 231 overall, Raymond Johnson, 3, defensive end, Southern Georgia. More depth at a position of need. RJ3 has potential. Small school, and I like his build. 7th round, 244 overall, Taquan Graham, defensive tackle, Texas. You know Coach Flores and Chris Greer love building in the trenches. There you have it. I am certain that over the next 24 to 48 hours, the world will flip upside down with new rumors and medical stats and concerns. But for now, I believe the Dolphins will continue to build around Tua and reunite him with two of his former teammates, which will bode well in his development.